So let's begin. The whole issue about cerebral palsy is about walking. When parents come to us, you know, with a child who's not able to walk by 18 months of age, their first question is, when will my child walk? Their main complaint is, doctor, my child is not walking properly. When a therapist is treating a child, you know, he or she will use A4s, you know, stretching exercises, strengthening to make the child to stand and walk better. And most of the surgeries we do in cerebral palsy are to make the child to walk better, you know. So walking is a very important part of cerebral palsy. And as these talks are going on by Chastalal and me, if any one of you have any questions, just note down this number. You can WhatsApp these questions to me, 9320329888. So as Chastalal is giving the talk in the next session after I finish, if you have any questions, send these questions. And I will be able to take her with Chastalal and ask her these questions and get answers. So, you know, let it be an interactive sessions for all of us. So, you know, the issue is, you know, very few of us are lucky enough to have a 3D instrumented gait analysis. And does it mean that people who don't have a gait analysis lab cannot do a gait analysis? It's really not correct. You know, of course, this is Jim Gage, and he said that human eye cannot recalibrate, recollect, and replay, and that's why we need a lab. But you can recalibrate, recollect, and replay even without a lab. And all you need is something to capture the video, and that's in form of a digital camera, and now in form of a simple smartphone. If you have a simple smartphone with a stand, you have your own visual gait analysis lab. So what I am going to go through is some of the prerequisites of how to take a good video. And this is very important skill, how to take a video, because only when you have a standardized video, you know, you can look at it well, you can send it to other colleagues, you can present in a conference. And let me take you through some of the, you know, tips and tricks of that. So the first is about how to take video from the front. So this is a child with cerebral palsy. I'm a clinic at Jalandhar with Dr. Saini, and we are trying to see how we can capture walking of this child. And this is how the therapist over there recorded the video. What is wrong with this video? It is that the video is taken at a higher level and we are looking at the child below, so that, you know, it's not a proper angle. Second issue is that we are not actually able to see the walking of the child. It is seen in first few seconds and then we completely lose and the camera goes on to the trunk and the head. So the right amount of information which we should get from a frontal video is not seen here. What is the foot progression angle? How are the knee? Okay, what is happening to the pelvis? Is it leveled or not leveled? So all this information is not available and this is not a good way to take a video. Let's look at now the second video. Now, this is something which is better. 1 second. And now you can see that we are able to see the whole child from head to toe. And you can see that throughout this video, I'm able to see head to toe of the child. Now, this is using a function called zoom out. Initially, we zoom in the child, and as the child keeps walking towards us, we use our pinch on a smartphone. And what we are going to do by using this pinch, slowly zoom out the child so that child always remains in the frame of the camera. Now, second thing what you will realize in this video is the level of the video is at hip of the child. Always, you know, we stand and take a video and keep camera at our shoulder level, and that gives rise to wrong projection. So here you sit down and take a video, and that gives steadiness and also allows us to record this video in a good way. So this is how a frontal video should be taken. You know, use a zoom out function and have the level at the child's hip. Okay. Now, this is also a video of the child having hemiplegia. I am interested in recording ankle and foot. So I'll record another video with more zoom function, and the child is zoomed. Okay, so that you can see from knee to ankle and then see the child walking. And the information which we get from this video is even better than what you get from a 3D gait analysis lab, because 3D gait analysis lab is not able to show you good ankle and foot kinematics. You know, it's very important that we learn to take a good video. After that, don't forget to again see the child from back, because certain things like heel varus or valgus or equinus, they are better appreciated on a video from back than video from front. So take a video from front and back, and we have learned. Now let's see how to take a side video. So this is a video which is taken from side. Patient is entering the frame and then exiting on the other side. What are the mistakes here? Again, like the previous video, this is taken from top. The therapist is standing, keeping the camera at the therapist's shoulder level or the eye level, and looking down on the patient. We should never look down upon our patients, you know, literally. Actually, what we should be doing is come to the level of the patients. If you want to treat them well or need to recognize their gait patterns, you know, come to the level of our clients or the patients. So this is not a good way to do. Another problem is the child is entering frame from one side and then going on to the other side. And in the process, what really happens is the angle, which is the knee making, you know, between the femur and the tibia, you will keep on missing it. At end of the, you know, this slide or end of the visual field, it's a different angle. In the center, it's a different angle, and on the left, it's a different angle, and the perception can definitely change. A better way to do this, there are two ways to do this. So this is a technique which is known as panning. And in this technique, what happens as the child walks, child is walking from one side to the other, but your camera is being angled. So as the camera gets angled, the child always remains in center of the field. So that's a one of the techniques while taking a side video. The third way actually to do a proper side video is to walk along the patient. And when you walk along the patient, what happens is, as I'm showing here, you know, the child always remains in center of the frame and the angles don't get distorted. Okay. Moment you angle your camera as it's happening here, you can see there is, you cannot appreciate the flexion in the child's ankle or knee or the hip any longer. So it's very important to stay parallel to the child's walk and walk along with the child. And what we have learned here, when you take a side video, again, I will summarize, is that be at the hip level of the child, okay? Walk along the child and keep the child in center of the frame to take a good side view. And always take side view from left as well as right, because in many children with cerebral palsy, it may be asymmetrical pathology. Some are left-sided, some are right-sided problem. And if you take video only from one side view, you will miss pathology on the other side. Some more tips are you must take a good front light, you know, whenever you're taking a video. So in a room, you must select the patient facing the light. The light should not come from back of the patient. It will blur the video. Clear, non-distracting background. So people walking around, you know, distracting things happening on the background, you must avoid. And lastly, record at normal speed. There are a lot of therapists I know, they are orthopedic surgeons, they record at a slow speed because that's available in their Android or a iPhone camera. But always record at normal speed. You can watch as a slow motion, but record as a normal speed. What all videos do we need to record? So I would record frontal head to toe, frontal hip to toe, frontal knee to toe. So three videos from front. Then I will record back head to toe. That's the fourth video. And I will record right side and left side video. So total six videos are recorded every time we see a patient. Okay. So one more question is how to take frontal and sagittal sync videos. You know, you see these fancy gait lab videos where, you know, child is seen walking towards you and perpendicular to you. And I'll show you a very simple trick to do this. This can be done using two phones. All you require is two phones, two stands. So these are simple selfie stands, which are available on any of the online stores. It's available on Amazon, on Snapdeal, on Flipkart. And with each, you get this button, which where you can start taking the video. So what you do is put two cameras, one on each stand. Let the child walk. And when the child comes into the frame, you know, click both the click buttons at the same time so that you can get a video like this. A video like this is possible to do without GitLab, you know, having frontal view and the side view. And then once you have the two videos together, use a video editing software and insert these two into that software so that you get the child walking towards you and on the side, so that the different changes which take place in the gait cycle, in the different stance phase, swing phase, you know, there are 8 stages. You can appreciate it very well, what is happening in the frontal plane and what is happening in the sagittal plane. The lastly, I want to show you how to watch a video, and it's important that we watch the slow motion. The fast motion, that's how the video was recorded. But when you suddenly see this in slow motion, you know, suddenly the whole perspective changes. The time freezes. You have time to look at different phases of gait cycle. You have time to look at what is happening at ankle, knee, and hip joint. So always watch the videos in a slow motion. And there are a couple of software I want to recommend you. I think Chasnal will talk to you in detail about this. The software we use is known as Kinovia. It is free download software. And Kinovia shows, allows you to play it in a slow speed. It allows you to calculate angles. It allows you to freeze frame. So these are 3 functions in a software to watch video, which are important to be able to freeze frame, to be able to play as a slow motion, and to be able to calculate angles, because these are 3 functions which are required for a visual gait analysis. And if you don't have Kinovia, if you're not on laptop, you can also have several apps on a mobile phone which allows you to do these 3 functions: allow slow motion, frame by frame play, calculate angle. And this also allows you many times to draw different changes in the gait cycle, so that it can be used for patient education or for your own analysis. So with this, I'm going to stop the screen, and Chasnal, having learned how to take a video, now she can explain